everyone. In this video, we will cover the current affairs. I am Nuzhat Sana. For mobile optimized ebooks, please install GK Today Academy app. You can attend the quizzes on this app for better practice. And after that, you can also read the detailed explanation of the questions you have missed. For regular updates, please check our Telegram channel. The link is given in the description box. You can subscribe to it if you find it relevant. For hard copy books, you can visit our website gktbooks.com. Okay. Also, our latest initiative is UPSC Prelims Test Series for 2021 and 2022 in GK Today Academy app. So if you are appearing in UPSC prelims, you may consider joining this. So now without wasting any further time, let's get started. So today we'll be discussing most important MCQs for 6th of August 2021. Starting with my first question, who composed the theme song of India for Tokyo Paralympics 2020? So recently Sanjeev Singh, who is a specially abled or you can say Divyang cricketer, composed and sung the theme song of India for the Tokyo Paralympics. And the theme song was named as Kar De Kamal Tu. And it was launched by our Sports Minister of India, Anurag Thakur. So in the Tokyo Olympics, a record number of total 54 athletes from India will participate in 9 sports disciplines. Now talking about Paralympic Committee of India, it is the body responsible for selecting athletes to represent India at the Paralympic Games and other international athletic meets, and it was founded in the year 1992 and also known as Physically Handicapped Sports Federation of India. And the current president of this committee is Mr. Rao Inderjeet Singh. Now, who will be the flag bearer for Paralympics in Tokyo Games? It's Mariappan Thangavelu. Then the flag bearers for the opening ceremony of Tokyo Olympics were MC Mary Kom and Manpreet Singh. Now, who will be the closing flag bearer for Olympic Games? It would be wrestler Bajrang Punia. Apart from it, the official theme song for Tokyo Olympics, that is Tu Thanle, has been composed and performed by popular Indian musician Mohit Chauhan. Also do remember that PV Sindhu is the first Indian woman to win 2 Olympic medals. Why? Because recently she has won her bronze medal at Tokyo Olympics. Fine. Question number 2. Neliode Vasudevan Nambuthiri, who dies recently, was associated with which dance form? So he was a Kathakali artist belonging to Kerala. Actually, he was known for his vibrant portrayal of classical Kathakali dance, and also he was a scholar in Sanskrit and Hindu Purans. Apart from it, he was also a recipient of several awards like Kendra Sangeet Natak Academy, then Kerala Sangeeta Natak Academy Award, then there is Kerala State Kathakali Prize and etc. Now talking about Kerala, India's second village of book is to set up in a village in the state of Kerala. And the first village of book is in Satara district of Maharashtra. Now apart from it, the authorities of state of Kerala have removed the upper age limit for transgender college students who are seeking admission to numerous educational programs available in the state, universities and its affiliated schools. Okay. So this step has been taken to encourage the transgender students in the state to pursue various postgraduate and undergraduate educational programs. Now talking about some of the recent demises, Stan Swamy has been passed away and he is priest and tribal rights activist. Then President of Haiti, Jovenel Moïse, has been assassinated recently. Then also we have lost Sundarlal Bahuguna, who is the founder of Chipko movement, and the veteran athlete Milkha Singh has also been passed away. Do remember that Milkha Singh is the only athlete to win gold at 400 meter at Asian and Commonwealth Games. Question number 3. Who is the first Indian javelin thrower to enter the finals of the Olympic Games?
So recently, Neeraj Chopra qualifies for the javelin throw final on 4th of August 2021. And he topped the Group A qualification with a big throw of 86.65 meters. And this video was quite in news. Do remember that he is the first Indian ever to win a world title in track and field at under 20, and he belongs to Haryana Panipat. Now apart from it, Sydney McLaughlin has created a world record recently after winning the women's 400 meter hurdles in 51.46 seconds at Tokyo Olympics. And her previous record was 51.90 seconds. So do remember that she became the first woman to finish the race before 52 seconds in an event, and she belongs to USA. Also, Elaine Thompson is important. Why? Because at the Tokyo Olympics, she becomes the first woman to retain 100 meter and 200 meter Olympic titles, and she is from Jamaica. Being a four-time Olympian champion, she set a national and Olympic record of finishing 100 meter race in women's category in just 10.61 seconds. And she is the second fastest woman in the 200 meters race with a time of 21.53 seconds. Then there is Lovlina Borgohain, and she became the third Indian boxer after Vijendra Singh and Mary Kom to win a bronze medal at the Olympics, and she belongs to Assam. Do remember that she is the first female athlete and second boxer from Assam to represent India in the Olympics. Also, she became the sixth person from Assam to get the Arjuna Award. Fine. So these are some of the updates regarding Tokyo Olympics. Once Tokyo Olympics would be finished, we will completely and thoroughly cover it. So do not get worried. Question number 4. In which state the first Orchid Conservation Center of North India has been inaugurated? So recently the first Orchid Conservation Center of North India has been inaugurated in Chamoli district of Uttarakhand. And the main purpose of this center is to conserve orchid species and create ventures for tourism and livelihood for local people. You must know that all orchid species are protected under CITES, that is Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora. And this was enforced on 1st of July 1975. Now can you tell me on 1st of July we celebrate which of the things? At least three things you have to tell me. Talking about Uttarakhand, here new chief minister has been appointed recently, and who is it? Mr. Pushkar Singh Dhami. Now few days back, Uttarakhand has one yojana named as Mukhyamantri Vatsalya Yojana, and under this program 3000 rupees will be directly transferred into account of children who have lost their parents or the earning member of their family due to coronavirus pandemic. So free education, ration and health facilities would be provided to them till they attain the age of 21 years. Now apart from it, few days back, Madhya Pradesh has launched a public awareness campaign named as Ek Mask Anek Zindagi. Why? To spread awareness about wearing mask as a preventive measure towards controlling the spread of COVID-19. Also, to commemorate the 75 years of India's independence, Chhattisgarh will be launching an awareness campaign named as Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav from 12th of August. Question number 5. Who has been appointed as the Prime Minister of Armenia? So recently, Nikol Pashinyan, who is the chairman of the Civil Contract Party, has been reappointed as the Prime Minister of Armenia. And he was first appointed as the Prime Minister in the year 2018. So recently, President Armin Shrikishyan has approved Pashinyan's candidacy for the post of Prime Minister of Armenia. Talking about Armenia, it is a country in Asia and it lies in the mountainous region between Asia and Europe. Capital is Yerevan and the currency is Armenian dram. Now apart from it, Mr. Deepak Das has been recently appointed as the new Controller General of Accounts. Then there is Ismail Hamieh. He has been re-elected as the leader of Palestinian Islamic group called as Hamas. Now can you tell me who has been recently appointed as the chief of CPEC authority? What is CPEC? It is China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. So recently, Khalid Mansour has been appointed for this post and he has replaced Asim Saleem Bajwa. This CPEC is a collection of infrastructure projects actually that are under construction in the regions of Pakistan and China, and it was established on 22 May 2013. Now apart from it, who is the first Muslim to be nominated as the ambassador at large for international religious freedom? It is Rashid Hussain. Then we have new Director General of Artillery, and who is it? Lieutenant General Tarun Kumar Chawla. Then new General Manager of South Western Railway is Sanjeev Kishore. Question number 6. Who launched the initiative Delhi at the Rate 2047? So recently, it has been launched by Arvind Kejriwal, and the aim of this initiative is to build partnerships with the private sector, CSR initiatives and philanthropic organizations to achieve the vision for Delhi by 2047 and make Delhi as the global city in the world. So the main objectives under this initiative are increasing Delhi's per capita income to Singapore's level and also providing 24/7 water supply before the upcoming elections so that they can bid for the 2048 Olympics, making roads as per the European standards and many other facilities. Now apart from it, Delhi government has recently approved 66% salary hike for MLAs. So now salary would be from 54,000 to 90,000. Also, Delhi government has approved its policy to promote medical oxygen production for providing incentives to private sector so as to invest in production plants, tankers and storage facilities for this medical oxygen. Okay, then obviously Delhi has a campaign named as Jahan Vote Wahan Vaccination. Already we have discussed about it many times. Then there is one more campaign named as Mukhyamantri COVID-19 Parivar Arthik Sahayata Yojana. So this is actually a social security scheme to provide financial assistance to families who have lost a member due to COVID-19, and under this scheme, 50,000 rupees would be provided to every family who have lost a member, and additional 2,500 rupees per month would be given if the deceased was the sole breadwinner. Fine. Means he was the only income earner in that particular household. Question number 7. Which bank has recently launched a new feature, SIM binding, for its mobile banking customers? So recently SBI has launched this feature named as SIM binding, and the feature has been added to SBI's YONO and YONO Lite digital banking systems to safeguard the interest of its customers. So this will actually protect the customers from various digital frauds. So what will happen is, after the addition of this feature, YONO and YONO Lite will work only on those devices which have SIM of mobile number which is registered with the bank. Okay, talking about SBI, it was formed on 1st of July 1955 under the Gorewala Committee, and before 1955 it was known as the Imperial Bank of India, which was formed in the year 1921 after merging Bank of Calcutta, Bank of Bombay and Bank of Madras. And the current chairman of SBI is Dinesh Kumar Khara. And do remember that SBI is India's largest government bank. Now apart from it, recently DBS Bank has been honored as the global winner for most innovative in digital banking 2021. And the bank was also recognized as the Asia Pacific winner and won in the cyber security category for its secure access and remote working solutions. Now, can you tell me which bank has recently launched a saving account named as Health and Wellness Saving Account? So, this has been launched by Suryodaya Small Finance Bank. Why? To provide support during medical emergencies. Now, apart from it, recently RBI has empaneled IndusInd Bank as an agency bank to RBI, and now it will handle the transactions related to government business. So now, on behalf of the state and central government, the bank can now facilitate the transactions. Fine. Question number 8. At which place Deaf Expo 2022 is scheduled to be held? So this has been scheduled to be held from 11th to 13th March 2022 in Gandhinagar, Gujarat. Actually, Ministry of Defense organizes military exhibitions in form of the Defense Expo and the Aero India every 2 years. And this Deaf Expo is basically the land and naval systems show of the Defense Ministry. And the last edition was held in Lucknow. And before 2014, it was used to be organized only in New Delhi. Now, apart from it, which country hosted the G20 Culture Ministers meeting recently? So it has been hosted by Italy. And the main focus was to promote ideas related to the protection of cultural heritage. Then recently, India has hosted the BRICS Counter-Terrorism Working Group meeting 2021. Question number 9. In which state Har Hit Store scheme has been launched recently? So this scheme has been launched recently by Manohar Lal Khattar, who is the Chief Minister of Haryana. And the scheme has been launched to encourage the students towards self-employment. Hence, under the scheme, a chain of grocery shops will be opened in rural and urban areas to sell the best quality daily needs products at reasonable prices. And for the implementation of the scheme, HAICL, that is Haryana Agro Industries Corporation Limited, signed trade off terms, that is TOT, with 51 corporate companies which will provide quality product to these stores, and they will also provide information technology support system. Fine. Now, Haryana was also in news because recently, under the Crime and Criminal Tracking Networking System, Haryana Police secured the first rank in the country, and then it was further followed by Gujarat Police at second position, and then Himachal Pradesh were at third position. Fine. Coming to last question, who has become the first brand ambassador of Home Lane, an interior design decor startup? So Mahendra Singh Dhoni has become the first brand ambassador of Home Lane, and he is now the first celebrity to endorse an end-to-end home interiors brand. Talking about Home Lane, it is an interior design decor startup founded by Shrikant Iyer and Tanuj Chaudhary in the year 2014. And it is known for providing personalized and professional interior services on time. And it is currently providing services in 16 Indian cities. Now, apart from it, recently Paras Khadka has retired, and he is the former captain of Nepal cricket team. Do remember that he is the first batsman of Nepal to score century in ODIs as well as T20s. Also, he was the longest serving captain of Nepal cricket team. Talking about ICC, that is International Cricket Council, it is headquartered in Dubai, and Greg Barclay is the current chairman of ICC, and Anil Kumble is the chairman of ICC's cricket committee. Fine. Now let's start with today's quiz. Here on the slide you can see 5 questions which have been taken from the past 2-3 days current affairs. Pause the video and try to solve each of these questions, and at the end of the lecture, do not forget to share your scores in the comment section. So please be honest and do not cheat with yourself. So that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. These were the important news and events from today, and we will meet again tomorrow with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching, and please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Minuzat Sana signing off.